Piyush Goyal in Mumbai, Dr. Balachandra Mungekar of the Congress in Delhi, Rashid Kidwai, senior journalist in Delhi, Dr. Subramaniam Swamy of the Janata Party, Atul Kumar Anjan of the Left, and Lord Meghnad Desai, one of India's best known economists and political thinkers. Thank you very much, gentlemen. This is a fantastic left Congress, NDA, Janata Party, and BJP panel that we have on the News Hour tonight. Thank you very much indeed. Well, Piyush Goyal, you know, you're being accused of obstructionism, of being so obstructionist in your entire approach that you will not even hesitate to be anti-poor if required. That's the charge that Sanjay Nirupam laid out in Parliament.
It was quite humorous because 65 years after independence, 55 of which this government and Congress-led coalitions have been in power, the poor still have to go hungry for food. I think the whole indictment is on the Congress themselves. That all that they have to promise.
Are you today, against the food security
finish,
bill?
Arnab, thoda dusro ko bolne diya karo yaar.
Are you against the bill?
Can I finish?
Yeah.
Okay, so kindly hear other people out sometimes. The basic question here is, 65 years after independence, the people of this country are poor thanks to the Congress, thanks to the mismanagement. And the only thing I can see out of the food security bill, which Mr. P.C. Chidambaram has acknowledged on the floor of the House, is that he has provided only 5,000 crores additional. There is no other new money.
No,
all they want to do is probably do some more corruption and add one more gate to your list of gates.
May I now add one more corruption scandal.
They are trying to do is bring in a promise which can only help to fill up their coffers more. So you will have a food gate coming up very soon.
Other than that,
Mr. Sanjay Nirupam has only homilies to give any claims that they want to do something for the poor. If he wants to do something for the poor, tell him to go and see Gujarat. Tell him to go and see Chhattisgarh. Tell him to go and see Madhya Pradesh, where the poor actually get food subsidized at low cost and there's nobody going hungry. That's what Sanjay Nirupam needs to do, not make promises of a right to food.
Do I have your permission?
Which has nothing to do with the people.
Do I have your permission to ask a question? The point is, say all this in the Rajya Sabha. Say all this in the Rajya Sabha. 1 minute.
Hang on,
I want to respond to this. One minute, please. This is completely baseless. No, it's not.
Say it in the Rajya Sabha but so
you're not
that
letting
this government
speak.
Gets off. They want to get off the hook.
They want to somehow divert attention from these gates.
I said, and start talking about it in Rajya Sabha.
Okay, you won't let me speak, but I will nevertheless, without halting, complete what I have to say. Even if the government passes the food security bill in the Rajya Sabha, they face a huge hurdle in the Lok Sabha. They face a hurdle in the Rajya Sabha where the numbers are not on their side. You can hold up the bill if you want there. What you are doing now is giving a situation where the government will go and say, look there, the opposition is so uncooperative and disruptive. We cannot help the Aam Aadmi because of you. 1 minute. Balachandra Mungekar, my question to you on the contrary is this. Explain this extreme anxiety to pass the food bill. What happened? If I'm not mistaken, this bill has been pending since 2011.
And where is the 2 lakh crores required for it?
That is absolutely right. Arnav, I would begin by saying that by this obstructionist method, BJP is making crime against the nation. Just crime is the only word.
What about the corruption? That's good for the nation.
Land acquisition.
The corruption is good for the nation.
I will come to that. Please, Piyush. BJP is obstructism. BJP is making crime against the nation by obstructing the land acquisition bill, blocking the development process, and by opposing the food security bill. It is a crime against
the
poverty.
What is the law minister,
BJP
the railway minister,
the sports minister, all of them are doing service to the nation. Please, Mr. Piyush, we know it. You don't conduct the discussion. My point is, today, I have got regard for Mr. Jaishmi and Sushma Ji Swaraj. Do they understand the implication of resignation of the Prime Minister? Does it mean that the resignation of the entire government? Are they ready for the election?
Yes, we are
Why
ready.
Why they are not
yes.
bringing no confidence motion?
Mr. Mungekar, we are ready.
Who is BJP to preemptive? I am sorry, who is BJP? A political party in this country cannot arrogate itself to such power that they can undertake upon themselves the job of the judiciary. Why don't you wait up to Wednesday? The entire message is under process. Ashok Chavan has resigned in Adarsh case within 24 hours. Chief Minister
because of
Maharashtra.
Mr. Shachit resigned in 24 hours.
What a corruption.
Well, here you have an open and shut case.
And still he was not resigned. and ultimately yes to remove, and he started his own political party. BJP is talking about the corruption. You don't believe in democracy.
Incidentally,
you believe in autocracy. You believe in ekachalakani vartitva autocratic government. Basically, I have read from 1925 your entire modus operandi.
Why don't you discuss both? No, I say no. Why
after
don't you, Mr. Mungekar? This is a. I'm sorry to say this, but this is increasingly beginning to look like a fixed match, where the BJP says we'll talk about all the gates and you say we'll talk about the food bill. I want to get an Atul Kumar Anjan, third voice here tonight.
Mr.
Atul Kumar Anjan, what do you want? Do you want a discussion on Colgate and Railgate in Parliament? Or do you, Mr. Atul Kumar Anjan, want an immediate discussion on the food bill? In the interest of the Aam Aadmi, will you be willing to sacrifice discussing Railgate for two more days?
Arna, one minute.
Let me ask him the question.
The interest of the Aam Aadmi is that the corruption stops. The interest of the Aam Aadmi is not just a promise.
Sure.
They want money which goes out of the government coffers.
Atul Anjan.
To be spent for the poor.
Atul Anjan.
Arnab ji, the way Piyush, what you are doing, the Rajya Sabha or Lok Sabha, that cannot be replayed here over it. Let us have a discussion very fairly. That is the charge against the opposition, which you are trying to prove with your action. Let's discuss what Congress says. I think Congress says that the opposition are disturbing the parliament. Why we are disturbing the parliament? Why these all one after other, the scams are coming up? Should opposition keep quiet? The opposition has a mandate from the public that they should speak very clearly about the lapses of the government. If the opposition fails to do this one, I think the people will not forget their role and people will punish them. And so,
what about the food bill?
Right.
What about the food bill? What about the food bill?
Just a minute. I tell you, Arnav, listen one thing. In the last UPA government, UPA one, they thought that bailing out some farmers, they will get the votes of the farmer. And when they came back again, UPA 2, they thought it was the biggest boon for them. Now this food bill, which we, the left, was the originator of this one. And in many states now, I just want to say.
No, is it about ownership?
Tamil Nadu,
is it about who owns the bill? Is it about ownership?
Listen, Arnab, 1 rupee kilo. No, where? Almost in 8 states, big states, where the poverty line is very, very clear. This is being practiced. Now at the fag end of this parliament session, you are bringing this bill with a motive. I just want to ask, why you are not bringing the seed bill, which has not seen the light from 2002?
Were you in the government? Were you in the government? Mr. Anjan, let me ask you, were you in the government when the farm loan waiver was announced? Were you in the government?
No, we demanded at that.
Were you in the government?
We demanded this.
No, were you in the government?
We demanded this right.
Were you in the government then?
No, we were supporting from outside.
So you were supporting from outside, so it was all right because you could take.
Outside.
No, no. So I'm sorry, Mr. Anjan. But that's
no,
a straight line of contradiction that I find that in your argument.
I am taking a very principled position.
No, you.
I am taking a very principled position.
It's a convenient position.
That why government has not brought it back in the last time. Why they have not suggested.
Mr. Anjan.
It's a political gimmick.
Mr. Anjan.
I tell you, the people of this country are noticing each and every step of this UPA SG SMS government, Sonia Gandhi, Sardar Manmohan Singh government, and they will take necessary steps when the elections are there.
You have avoided my question. I moved to Subramaniam Swamy and other panelists, but you have very conveniently avoided my question because
no,
I just pointed out.
That at the fag end of this government, why have they brought this bill?
So
they should have brought it in 5 years back. Where is the money
simple,
for the
there
bill?
Is a simple counter to
where
that.
Where is the money? First tell them to show us where the money is.
One second.
Why do they want to fool the people again and again? And now the time is gone. People don't get fooled by these stupid problems.
It's fine. Just because the BJP and the left, just because the BJP and the left get together. No, but just because
every minister is tainted.
It's not the BJP and the left. It's the common man, common sense.
What people will think.
Sir, I'm sorry.
You are not committed for that.
Mr. Anjan,
one minute. A discussion. And I just want to tell you, Arnab, one thing. The same way Indira Gandhi at the fag end in 1974, before imposing the election, many legislation were brought and got cleared. And what happened later on?
What happened to the left?
What happened later on?
What happened?
The same fate this government will also see.
Okay, fine. Now, let me.
In 1977.
Today, I find that the BJP and the left are in a very, aggressive mood.
At the very outset, I said
to Piyush that your type of functioning is not allowed.
No
but
wonder.
At the same time, I say within there is a perception.
No wonder.
Government
it's very
is
difficult.
Not interested. They are it's, not fair enough sir, to bring this bill in a good mood. They are trying to take political mileage.
I can only say.
This will
I can
not
only
be,
say.
You see. Taken seriously.
On a lighter note, if I am permitted one, I can only say that I can completely understand why the government, which was supported by both the left and the BJP, fell down. It is very difficult for anyone else to have their say when both of you get going. Subramaniam Swami, my question to you is this.
Arunav, congratulations, Arunav.
What have I done now?
You exposed a series of scams one after the other so that the people of the nation realize how bad this government is.
This is the first time anybody...
And Mundrekarji, as a good citizen of India, has congratulated.
On a lighter note, this is the first time anybody from the Congress party has congratulated me in the last decade. Thank you very much, Mr. Mungekar. I am touched. Subramaniam Swami, on food bill versus Railgate, which one would you choose and why?
Well, both are scandalous, and the food bill is a bill. If you look at the numbers, it's a totally unworkable thing. It's obviously a instrument by which more corruption is going to take place. You're going to according to the numbers given out by the NAC, 1 lakh crores would be spent to provide 90% subsidy for food for 67% of the population. I don't think the Indian government has that kind of machinery. Mrs. Gandhi tried this when she nationalized the wholesale trade, and within 1 year she apologized to the traders and said, please take it back, we can't manage it. So I don't think there's any difference between Railgate. This food bill is one more scandal that we are, or one more food gate, you might call it, that we are going to have in the UPA government.
Do you think it's a diversionary tactic, Mr. Swami?
No,
it's not a diversion. It's just a reflection of the bankruptcy of the UPA. They don't know what to do.
And you are saying this because it makes the NDA feel a little politically insecure. The large number of people who it is going to touch, the number of people it will bring into possibly the Congress vote bank.
It will be a non-starter. By the time they get moving, the elections will come. Public will realize what it is. And the UPA will be voted out.
Subramaniam Swami, you're getting a counter from the Congress, but I like to say this: 75% of rural India, 50% of urban India. In other words, 46% of rural and 28% of urban households.
They don't have the machinery, and that too an honest machinery, to reach this kind of numbers.
Arnavji.
Tamil Nadu, Subramaniam Swami,
Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, West Bengal, Pondicherry, and many parts of other the Jharkhand and this Chhattisgarh, the food is given free, almost 1 rupees per kg. What is new in this program? We want to discuss in Parliament threadbare, but at the fag end of the Parliament, when 2 days are left,
well,
this government has brought this one. It is not a good intention bill. A politically motivated bill.
Meghnad Desai.
Tell me.
Lord Meghnad Desai, Mr. Mungekar, 1 minute. My question to Lord Meghnad Desai is this, sir. Do you think, you know, the BJP will be able to derail the political advantage that the food security bill brings? That's one. B, what will matter more in terms of political perception? The food bill or the numerous scams that the government is being hit by?
I think the food bill is more serious consequence for the long run than any scam is. Scams will go on happening in every government. I mean, scams are not new, they'll go on happening. And they'll go on shouting at each other. But the food bill commits us to an entitlement which is so serious that if it were irreversible, we would have a great crisis if the harvest failed. You don't realize what it is to commit to give 60% of the population free food, more or less. Now, the public distribution system has inefficiency of up to 40%, as Jean Drees has admitted that, and Jean Drees is a friend of the poor. Now, a 40% wastage in a scheme like this, which is going to cost 6 lakh crores for 3 years, means you're actually wasting 2.5 lakh crores.